Is it possible that a $70 Bluetooth and app-based diagnostic unit will work with your BMW? Today, we look at a diagnostic unit recommended by one of my viewers named Haval. I hope I've got that right. And this unit is from Autel, or Autel, and it's the AP200. And it connects to your car using the OBD2 port, and then connects to your smartphone using Bluetooth. Let's go out and give it a try. Well, we're out in the car. Let's have a look at the Autel MaxiAP 200. It works via an app on your phone, so let's see if we can't get it to work with our BMW. Okay, we should put that up on the screen there so you can see it. Now, when you open it up for the first time, you'll have to put in some registration information, your email address and password. And that's under the Me setting. In the center little icon at the bottom is called Mal. I don't know if you can see that there. That is where, once you install the software, you choose your vehicle type. So you can see already that I've chosen BMW there. It's unzipped it. It's 1.39 gigabytes. So make sure you're on Wi-Fi at the time, and that will take a few minutes to install. But you need to do that before you'll get anything useful out of your BMW at all. So then we can switch back to the home screen. Now we'll see if it works. The key is in the ignition. Some vehicles you'll have to hit the engine start stop, but not this one. So let's try diagnostics. Let's see what we get. Now here you've got to wait for this to refresh, which is a little bit strange, but and then choose BMW from the list. There's a demo there, there's a standard EOBD, which just gives you the standard SAE codes, which are absolutely useless for a BMW. It needs the BMW code specifically, or you're not going to get anything. So we'll click on BMW there. We'll choose automatic selection. It's looking for our VIN number. Okay, we'll go read on that. Reading our number, and if we agree that it hasn't found one out of the thin air, then we'll go okay to that if it matches. How it could not match, I have no idea, but whatever. Okay, so here we are. Confirm the vehicle. Once again, what else is it going to be exactly? Okay, we'll confirm, yep. Now, off it goes. Okay. It does have a vehicle profile, which we've already seen. So we go back and we'll go to diagnosis. Let's see. Auto scan. Ooh, 8 faults on the engine. Lovely. Wow, this is showing real promise. There's hope here. Okay, that's 100%. We have many, many faults. We'll look at the engine faults just to see if it's on the right track. We'll choose engine on the little arrow at the side. Okay, we have our ECU information. We'll see what's that. Nothing too drastic, but you may want to know the programming date when it was last updated. We'll just go back and we'll read the codes. Okay, what we have here is a number of codes. A lot of them are not present. I'm assuming they're codes that have the problem has been fixed. Let's have a quick look. Like we have here the air mass flow sensor 4BC2. That's not present. This was something I fixed a little while ago. So we'll look at the little symbol here is a little snowflake, which is their symbol for freeze frame. So we'll click on that. and it's some kilometers ago. It's back when I replaced the mass airflow sensor. So it's a code that has been corrected. So we can ignore all of these, or we can erase them and then see what sticks. But for the moment, I'm just glad that these codes have come up. It shows that this unit is actually working with a BMW properly. And that's a very encouraging first step. Okay, we'll just go back there and we'll choose one that is present. So right up the top, the second one down is the particulate filter system. And if we click on the freeze frame for that, we can see that there's something wrong. The differential pressure over the particulate filter is zero. So there's something going wrong. It's definitely never going to be zero. So since it was something I was just working on, there's a chance there that I haven't plugged in something quite properly, or the sensor has failed. Okay, we're not going to go through each of these codes, although I will check out each one to make sure that either I've fixed these problems or I'm going to fix them very soon. Okay. But the thing to take away from this is these match up exactly with what you get when you plug in the BMW diagnostic software on a laptop. This little app is working like it should. Before we leave the diagnosis menu, there's something you need to see here. If you go into, for example, the engine module, just clicking on the little arrow on the right hand side of it, you can have a look at the ECU information. You can read the codes, erase the codes, but here's the nice feature. There's live data. So if we click on that, we can see some live information. It can be very handy. So we'll start with the charging. And charging doesn't mean battery charging. For the engine, it means turbocharging. Much nicer. So we'll click on charging. And we can see here straight away we have some pressures and some temperatures. So even though the car isn't on at the moment, it does tell us that those sensors are reading pretty close to accurate, which is a good starting point. Of course, you can start the car and see if they move as they should. We'll just go back, however, and go through the other live data to see if there's anything interesting. The exhaust emission system is where we're going to find any particular strangeties, and here we go. See that we have one very odd thing going on here. We have exhaust gas back pressure at zero. That was the error that we looked at that I thought was a bit strange. So we'll start the car up and we'll see if that changes or whether that problem continues. Okay, I don't know if you can see there, we've got some exhaust temperature changing. But the exhaust gas pressure is still zero, so there's definitely something I need to check there. So this live menu is really quite handy, one of the better features so far on this app. And of course you can see here, if you have a diesel car, you can see when the regeneration has happened, that it's not happening at the moment, and that it's enabled. So that is very, very good information. So we'll just go back, we'll go back to charging just quickly. And you can see there we have our pressures, our charging pressure, our charge air temperature, and we'll see if we give it a few revs, we can see that they rise as they should and drop back down. So everything is working there. Okay, we'll just go back from charging, we'll go to the fuel system while we have the car running. And you can see there we have fuel temperature, we have rail pressure specified, that's what the car is asking for, and rail pressure actual, which is what the fuel system is giving. So if we give it a bit of fuel, we can see that it's asking for 509, it's getting, well, it jumps around, of course, very quickly, moving all the time, but we ask for 500, eventually it hones in and we get 500, so everything is looking pretty good there. Okay, we'll go back again. Well, multifunction steering wheel, look into that one later. Okay. Okay, operational values, this should be interesting. And once again, we have a bunch of good information here. A lot of this is very similar to when you plug a laptop in with the BMW software. So it's good things to know. You can see that it all is updating. There's nothing that's sitting where it shouldn't be. You can see when you put your clutch in, yep, it's brake light on. Brake light, yep, braided, yep. We've got a good voltage. The ambient temperature is reading correctly. The intake air temperature isn't that much different to the ambient, so we know that the sensors are reading correctly. This is super. Really good information for every BMW owner. This is, for the price of this, I'd say this is the minimum diagnostic you should have with you at all times. And maybe it's worth checking all of these things once a month to make sure your BMW is running properly. We'll just go out of that. Okay, we've checked everything, so we'll just switch off that. Switch off the engine there. And of course we can check codes till we go blue in the face. I know I have something to check already. And that, I think, okay, yes, we do want to exit. And yes, we do want to exit. And yes, we do want to exit. We'll look at the vehicle service this time, second down. Now this is where we have some features that are really quite handy. Let's see if they work, for example. Now just say you had some new fuel injectors, you have to get them programmed in with their code. So let's have a look. We'll click on that. Yes, it's a BMW, that's what we're working on. Okay, we'll choose automatic selection since there's no choice. Yep, please read the VIN. Yep, that's a bit of a... Okay. Yes, correct, confirm vehicle, yes. Okay, we got diagnosis and hot function. What's hot function? Let's have a look. Okay, correct your fault before whatever. Okay, perfect. It's telling me what the codes are already on the injectors. And here we can enter new calibration values. Now I haven't just put new injectors in, but the fact that this is here saves you a trip to the mechanic, or saves you plugging in the laptop with the BMW software. This is a worthwhile addition. Let's escape out of this. We don't want to do any of this right now, so we'll end that. Go back. Yes, so we clicked exit, and back some more, and I did indeed click exit. Let's go, and back again. But it looks like we have a number of good features. If you have a new battery, you can use the, you can update the battery management system, update the worn brake pad sensor if you put a new one in. Fantastic, that saves you fiddling around. The brake bleeding system is perfect. That allows you to control the brake bleeding from the app instead of plugging in the laptop. So very handy. In the DPF here, so we'll read that VIN number and we'll OK to that. And we'll go, yes, yes, that's the vehicle, same as it was a minute ago. Thank you. Okay, and we'll go to hot function. Let's go to hot function. And here we can either set that we've replaced the diesel particulate filter, or after we've given it a proper clean. If you've seen my other video, you'll know what I'm talking about. Or we can request regeneration. Now, you shouldn't need to request regeneration, but perhaps you've been stuck driving in the city for short trips for a month and your car has no chance to regenerate and you want to force it to. It looks like we click on here and we can do that. A good feature, could be handy on occasion. It does look like all of these features are functional. So we'll exit out of that. And again, yes, we do. That's why we click exit. So the few other functions here that could be very handy, resetting throttle adaptations, things like that. When you put in new windows, new seats, new headlamps, all useful things. Vehicle history. Every time we plug the unit in, it leaves a little record for us, so we can see if we're making things better or worse over time. That pretty much covers everything. I think we'll consider that to be a useful app and a useful device, well worth the money. It could save you its purchase cost with one fault that you don't have to go to the mechanic to get checked out, so, or the BMW dealer. So well worth every dollar. And there you have it. The AP200 was in fact successful in diagnosing the BMW. I'm not saying it's the perfect unit, but for the $70 price tag, it's a bargain. I don't think you'll find anything that does as good a job as cheaply. The important thing is, it did find the error codes that are BMW specific, and that makes it a winner. If you like this video, please give it a like, and if your friends would be interested, please share it with them. And of course, if you want to help me make more videos like this, hit that subscribe circle. Until next time.